Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Belfast for the MTK Global Show. With me, we've got Irish amateur star Kurt Walker. Kurt, I've just been speaking to Danny Vaughan there. He sings your praises. For the people that don't know, just tell the people about yourself.
I've been boxing 12 years. I have 12 national titles. And then titles, as a youth, I won European silver, world bronze. And then I moved into the seniors. Won 3 senior titles. My first medal was at the European Championships last year, where I won bronze. And then this year, I went to the Commonwealth, won silver.
In Australia, yeah?
Yeah, in Australia. And then the person who beat me, Peter McGill from England, I beat him in the European Union Finals 3 weeks ago.
A few weeks ago. So you're beating the top in the amateur game. So, again, what's the dream? I see you've got a wee cast on your hand, got a wee injury there.
I broke my hand the first round.
Oh, did you?
Against the fight, I was in a caster, just took off an egg, got 2 screws in it. It's all good, yeah, but Peter McGill's a top lad. You know, it was a great fight, so I'm just hoping I can push off that now and win a gold medal in Tokyo.
That's what I was going to mention. The Olympics is the next dream, is it?
That's the next bit. That's all I want, the Olympics, and then I'll go pro after the Olympics, and I have a good backing behind me. Like you're saying about Dan and all, like, I know all the boys, and we're all getting on well, and all it's good. Like, so I just want to, my main goal, I take it step by step, go to the Olympics first. Once I qualify, then my next step will be to win gold.
And that's the thing, a lot of people would say, getting to the Olympics is a dream. Yeah. The next person says, winning a medal at the Olympics is a dream. Your dream is just gold, that's it.
In some cases, getting the Olympics is harder than winning the medal.
Yeah.
The qualifications, it is very hard, like, but that's the thing, you have to take it step by step. You can't think too far, else you'll blow yourself out. Like.
Yeah, definitely. So, the dream is, you're 23 years old, just spoke a little bit off camera there. Olympics and then turn pro. You're obviously supporting a couple of Belfast boxers here tonight.
I'm here supporting Sean McComb.
Sean McComb. Talk about that, Sean McComb. How far do you think he can go?
Sean McComb is probably the hottest prospect in Britain right now.
Coming through,
he really is unbelievable. Danny will tell himself, Paddy Barnes will tell himself, everyone will tell himself, he's a boxing brain, he's unbelievable.
Well, Danny is a boxing man. I spend a lot of time with Danny because he's based in Scotland and that, and he sings your praises quite a lot.
I was over sparring Paddy for the world title fight, just because the fella's bigger and I'm bigger, so I was just over there at work. Me and Danny, I'd known Danny a few years now, maybe 2 years, but so Danny knows what I can do. Like, so Dan, that's why Danny's a good coach as well. So me and him have a very good relationship with each other. And plus, he's my mates Paddy and Sean are with him as well.
There
so
you go.
It's good. Like,
so when you do turn pro, are you looking at guys like what Paddy's done and even McConnell, Carl Frampton?
Yeah.
Like, Belfast is probably the fighting capital of Europe at the moment.
Yeah.
You know, guys like you coming through from the amateur ranks. I just want to touch on the McGrail fight and that. How did that fight go? Last couple of weeks back,
it was good. I lost the first round, and in the second I won it. It was close, very close round in the second, and then the third I won it all judges. So
you think that could be a rivalry that progresses in the pro ranks?
Yeah, that would be definitely a rivalry. He's beat me twice, I've beat him once, so hopefully we go on the fight show in Olympic final.
Well, that's
the
Olympic final right there, is it?
Yeah, I hope so.
So again, who else are you looking up to for tonight? I mean, Belfast has got a plethora of fighters out there.
There's loads of boxers, even Ireland, like Guy Colley behind you know, and there's just loads of, like, Mick Collins doing massive things.
Yeah.
He's selling out the Odyssey, he's going to sell out the Fila. It's madness, Mick Collins.
He's selling out Madison Square Garden.
He's going to be the next big thing. Like, Mick Collins will have a world title in the next 2 years, I'd say.
So what's your dream? Do you think you can cut when the torch gets passed from Frampton to Mick Collins to Kurt Walker?
When I was on the Irish team, Mick Collins was number one, I was number two for 3 years. I was always behind him, so like, we're good mates now.
You're wishing that Mick Collins would just turn pro and get number one spot, is that what it is?
No, it's just me and Mick have a good relationship, so it's good. I sparred him many times, and the talent he has, he really can't. He's unbelievable.
Well, Carl Frampton, he's fighting in a couple of weeks' time.
I'm going to.
You went to well, I'll be there as well, so I might see you there. What's your thoughts on this?
I honestly think Frampton's too good for him.
Yeah.
Too strong, too sharp. Like, I sparred Frampton in my club when I was 17 years old, and I know I was young, but he hits the hardest. Like, his jab is. Like, he throws a jab, and it feels like a brick's hitting you.
Oh, really?
He really does. I think he's going to be too strong for
Warrington. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, again, the name's Kurt Walker.
The name's Kurt Walker. Yeah. Look out for it.
Remember it. I'll be there in a couple
of days. King Kurt.
King Kurt, there you go. Oh, Kurt, thanks for this.
Sure, thank you.
Thanks, buddy.
See you later.